Saint Feuillien Belgian Coast IPA. Welcome to another edition of Bands, Bikes and Booze Reviews. This is the Belgian Coast IPA from the Saint Feuillien Brewery. And yeah, the name, Belgian Coast IPA. This is why, I know I keep going over this point, but this is why I will argue with anybody that the term IPA doesn't mean anything at all now. The style has just been completely and utterly bastardised, and the term for me, IPA, just is a marketing thing. Unless it's a traditional English IPA, then that's what it is, in my opinion, because obviously the Americans got hold of it. I really wish they'd have called it something else. I don't know why they called it an IPA. Maybe because they put quite a lot of hops in, and the original IPA did have hops in. Contrary to popular belief, that wasn't to preserve it on the journey over to the Indian subcontinent. It was basically people liked the taste of hops in beer, as is borne out today. So, you know, there's so many myths around the term IPA as well. But if you look at the video on my channel about the history of IPA, then you'll get an in-depth knowledge of what IPA is all about. But yeah, it's a bugbear of mine, to be honest. And as well as that, the fact that every craft brewer is calling everything that they do an IPA, more or less everything they do as an IPA. The default seems to be now just to throw a load of American hops in there, call it an IPA, and hope for the best. Now, that's a very flippant statement, I know, but there are some good craft brewers out there, don't get me wrong. But there are a lot of who I would consider not the best, if I'm putting that diplomatically, not the best. And this, again, I would say falls under that umbrella of being one of the bandwagon jumpers, basically coming out with an IPA. Belgium and IPAs, it was never a thing. It's not a tradition. They're literally jumping on the bandwagon, which, you know, if they want to do that, that's fine. I have no skin in this game, I'll tell you. But what I do get annoyed about is the fact that IPAs can be called, you can call any beer an IPA now. You know, you get black IPAs, you get white IPAs, you get West Coast, East Coast, Belgian Coast, traditional English IPAs, which are the de facto IPAs. I don't think you should do anything else unless you're brewing it in that style. You can argue that with me and I'll make my case, but as I say, I really don't hold much to the term IPA. I'm going to leave it there. I'm going to shut up about IPAs and the naming for a couple of minutes anyway. But this is what they call a Belgian Coast IPA. And basically what it is, it's an India Pale Ale. It says so on the side of the bottle. And it's got a mixture of British hops and American hops in there, in a Belgian beer. You work that one out, I'm not gonna. And it's one of these beers that come from a really good brewery who, in my opinion, don't really need to be doing this. Saint Feuillien are, for me, one of the more consistent brewers from Belgium. Everything I've tried so far from them has been really good. I've tried their doubles and their quadruple and it's been really nice. I have to say, it does stand out for me as being a really nice Belgian style of beer. But they also do the triples, which was really nice, and the blonde as well, which is renowned to be one of the best in the world. And I have to say, it was really good. And now they're available in supermarkets over here, which is even better. But this thing, I bought it just more out of curiosity than really wanting to try it. Belgian Coast IPA, fuck me. India Pale Ale. Oh, good Christ, help me. Sauvignon, of course, traditional Belgian brewer. They've been going since 1873, and they've been consistently brewing good beer since then. And they are based in the Walloon part of Belgium, the French-speaking part, in a place called La Roux. I think it's pronounced L-E-R-O-U-L-X. So I think that's La Roux, something like that. But as I say, they're good. So I'm hoping that this is going to be a good one as well. And I'll get onto the hops in the next section, but there's a really interesting selection of hops that they've got in here. So I'm just going to shut up and let's get on to the next section. Okay, so this is a 330ml bottle. This is a 5.5% beer. It hasn't got the IBUs on this, so I'm really not clued up as to how bitter or even what it's going to taste like. But there are 7 hop varieties in here, and it's also got on here dry hopping as well, which again, doesn't really mean much to me, to be honest. But 7 hops in a single beer, and I think, does it really need that? And I always go back to that analogy about Italian food. Now, I quite like Italian food. It's not my favourite style, but it is nice. But if you look at the traditional Italian recipes, they're very, very simple. They don't contain a lot of ingredients because a lot of it was peasants' food, and they didn't have a wide variety of ingredients to put into foods. But if you look, a lot of them are vegetarian. They don't contain meat. So again, it's very simple food, but they made the most of the ingredients. And I always liken that to beer. And when I see brewers putting in 7 different types of hops, I tend to think they're overcompensating for something. But the hops that they've got in here are, as I say, a mixture of American and British hops. For the British hops, you have got Brewer's Gold, Northern Brewer, and Fuggles. 3 good, solid British styles of hops, especially Fuggles. You'll find them in most British beers. They're a really nice, distinct type of British hop, or English hop, I should say. And they grow them down here in Kent. And I've actually seen them as a hop farm. There's a working hop farm not too far away from me, and they still grow them there. And along with Goldings, they're the staple of English hops. Now, the American hops that they've got in here are a little bit dodge. Cascade, I'm not a fan of Cascade hops. It tends to get overused, and a lot of contract brewers overuse it as well. And it doesn't taste that great. And some of the bad beers that I've tasted, there's a sort of a continuous theme of having Cascade hops in there. But it depends on how you use them. You know, if you use a lot of them, it's not going to be that great. But that's just me. That's just my opinion. That's just my taste. But they've got Cascade. They've got Magnum. They've got Citra. Now, of course, Citra is the first American hop to come over here. And I think that came over in the early 90s. And it's, again, a staple of all them American-style beers that are brewed over here. You find that a lot of craft brewers use them in beers now, both in the IPAs and in the pale ales as well, the American-style pale ales. You've also got Mosaic, which is quite a pleasant hop, quite a fruity, pleasant hop. I know that the Adnams Brewery, they do a Mosaic IPA, and that was quite nice. I really enjoyed that, and I think that's a single-hopped IPA as well. I could be wrong, but I think it's just a single hop, and it's got the Mosaic in there, and I really enjoyed that. That's on the channel. That was one of my earlier reviews when I was reviewing craft beer. As I said in a few videos, I've stopped doing that now. I think there's far too many beer reviewers reviewing IPAs and stuff like that. It gets far too much exposure. And the thing with craft brewers is they will brew beer, and the beer will only be available for short batches, and that's it. It will go. Whereas I like to review the traditional stuff that you can buy, and it's been going for years. So that's just me. Maybe I'm doing it wrong. Who knows? But there's your hops that are in here. It doesn't really give much information as on the brew sheet as to what other malts are in here, but the ingredients just say it contains malt, barley. What is the other stuff? That's about it, really. and the rest is in Flemish, but they do make a point about two brewing styles coming together, etc. I'm really intrigued, and it's probably the reason I bought it. I want to see if there's a Belgian take on this, and it's not just a mixture of American hops and British hops. So, with that in mind, let's get this open and let's see what's going on. Now, I've not had much luck with these bottles opening because they normally fizz up and go everywhere, so I'm going to see what happens with this one. Is it going to go Garrity? Let's have a look. No, thankfully not. Cap is just plain brass, nothing to see there. Let's get it into the glass. Now, on their website, they're using a traditional tulip glass. I have to say, the colour is a bit different. It's like a darkish amber, or bright amber, I should say. There's a haze on it. Let's get the rest in there. Yeah, it looks like there's some sediment in there, so there could be a little bit of a Belgian twist on here, but let's have a look. Wow, that's citrusy, really citrusy. And there's big orange and peach. They're the first two aromas that I get. And there's a little touch of clove in there as well. So it looks like the yeast that they put in here is a Belgian style yeast. That's giving off some clove-esque fennels. And that's about it, really. There's a little touch of spice, maybe a little touch of white pepper. So it looks like it's a mixture of three brewing styles, American, British, and, or English I should say, and Belgian as well. It doesn't look too bad, and I'm hoping from St. Feuillien, who are a good brewer, or consistent brewer from what I've had so far, I'm hoping this isn't going to let the side down, so let's find out. Bottoms up. Oh, now that's nice. That is really nice. That is very much like an English style IPA, but with the orange zest. Now, I mentioned earlier, I tried the Hook Norton Off the Hook IPA, which was really nice. That was a mixture of the two American and English hops and had a big undercurrent of orange zest, which I like in a traditional English IPA. The Fuller's Bengal Lancer has got that in there. The Cheddar Ales IPA has got it in there, which is a really good IPA. I really did enjoy that. And the Ridgeway IPA has got that in there as well. And it's got that nice orange zesty style seam running through it, which marmalade, that's the best way to describe it. But this has got it, but it's turned up to the max. It's quite nice. And there's a little touch of, as I say, the Belgian yeast, the clove style esters and fennels that you normally get, the spicy white pepper, the clove, etc. And maybe a little touch of coriander on there as well, but it's very subtle. Dominance in this is the hops, as you would expect, but it seems to be that the English hops are more dominant. There's a little subtle flavour of that peach that I got on the aroma, which is obviously coming from one of the American hops. Which one, I don't know. But there's an earthiness to it as well, which I think is coming from the Fuggles, and that gives it that English twist. The American hops don't dominate on this at all, but the orange that runs through it, that's big. That's the only real citrus that you get. But it's nice. I do like this. Mm. That's good. I think what they've done is this St. Feuillien. They obviously know what an English IPA tastes like. And I think they've gone with that more so than the American style, you know, which is over-hopped. There's a bitterness to it. A grapefruit resinous bitterness to it, which, you know, that's what the craft brewers go for. They've done that to an extent, but I think the hop content is more English in character than American. There is a bittering hop on the finish. That's where the bitterness comes from. There isn't much of a malt character on this as well. There is vague biscuit malt, which is sort of incidental. This is all about the hops. But there is a little bit of that Belgian yeast character in there too. Again, it's subtle. But it's nice. I quite like this. This, apart from the name, is not a bad stab at an IPA. So what's the verdict on Belgian Coast IPA from St. Feuillien? Well, I have to say, I was very sceptical at the start of this review. I saw the name and I just thought, you're taking the fucking piss here with this Belgian Coast IPA. But having drank it, I can sort of see that they were trying to keep things traditional with going more towards the English style of IPA. Now, I know orange zest probably isn't the traditional English style. I mean, the original style, you wouldn't have got that back in, you know, the 1800s when IPA was first conceived and exported over to India and wherever else it went. But they've sort of taken the tradition of the Fuller's Brewery, the Hook Norton, which have done this in the past, but also the other breweries as well, and they've tried to copy that. And I think I have to admit, but I think Fuller's were the first to do that. That's a bit of a signature with Fuller's. They do like to have a bit of a marmalade seam running through a lot of their beers. Obviously not London Pride and stuff like that, but certainly the Bengal Lancer, you do get it in there. And occasionally you get it in other styles that they do as well. But it's big on this. The orange is big. The orange zest is big, I should say. But again, you know, they've not lost their roots completely. They have got the subtle Belgian yeasty esters and fennels that you normally get with Belgian beer, and it, all in all, it does make quite an interesting beer. I have to say, it wouldn't be my go-to. If I saw that on a shelf and it said Belgian Coast, I would just say get a fuck. But I saw this on Beers of Europe, no, not Beers of Europe, House of Trembling Madness, and I'll tell you exactly how much it cost. House of Trembling Madness. Where is it? Oh, did I get it from here? No, I didn't. I got that from, was it Beer Sniffers? I got it from Beer Sniffers. I can't remember, but I got it a while ago. It's been in the fridge a while, and I've sort of been putting it off because I thought, meh, doesn't really appeal to me. But I have to say, it's quite nice. It's not the best beer, though. I'll drink this, and I will probably never buy it again, if you know what I mean, because if I'm going to be buying St. Feuillien beer, I'll be going for their double or their quadruple. I will not be going for stuff like this. However, if I was out and about in Belgium and I saw that and there was nothing else, then yeah, I would definitely go for it. But it's quite nice. It's quite refreshing too. And I've taken this out of the fridge, so it's chilled, but I'm still getting lots and lots of flavour from it. Yeah. Oh, lovely. Lovely strong orange. There's more fruit coming through now as well. Yeah, it's quite juicy actually. There's more of the peach that I got on the aroma that's coming through more. But the dominance is the orange zest, as I say. But it's nice. I like that. I'm gonna give it a 7 out of 10. I probably wouldn't buy it again, but it's very agreeable and it's going down very nicely. And it's only 5.5%, so it's not gonna break your heed, as they say in Scotland. But the name, it's starting to wind me up, so I'm going to stop the review here. All I'm going to say is that's not a bad beer. Probably won't buy it again, but I'm going to drink that and I'm going to enjoy it. And remember, beer is working class champagne.